Hi everyone, I'm Ibrahim Ulke from YouTube API Developer Relations team, joining you today from New York Studios. And today we'll talk about getting help with YouTube APIs. Either you are just a new developer starting to develop with YouTube APIs, or you are already building applications, the function, and you just want to create a new functionality, and you're having some problems. You may need some help, and we'll definitely help you. We are just trying to present like the best ways to get those help. To start with, I will go over like the four different ways to get the help. I will start with a demo. I'll start with the YouTube developer documentation. I'll talk about today the developer documentation first, and our API blog second, Stack Overflow third, and as the last one, using the issue tracker. Let's get it started. Let's talk about the developer documentation. So developer documentation is a sitemap on the left side, and you can let's think that you have like a problem with the version tree and you are trying to find a functionality. In getting started, you will see some help with registering your application, implementing the OAuth2 or authentication method, or getting the client libraries to start developing. In guides, you will see how to upload a video with the code samples or doing a resumable upload. As well as there will be some technical documentations like the difference between the channel IDs versus the usernames and the Google Plus IDs. Or you can be having like some problems and you want to actually migrate from client login to OAuth2. Then you'll have some like technical documentation here as well. Also, you'll have a detailed documentation on the reference site. You'll see all the resources here, like videos, channels, playlists, search, thumbnails. And let's think that you actually want to list the channels. You want to actually get some information about a channel of a user. And you actually want to use the list method call. Here you will see all the required parameters, the request itself, the filters, some optional parameters, and you will see actually the response here, how the response will look like. You will see in the response it will be a channel resource. You will see all the error codes and why they could be happening, as well as at the end you will see an API Explorer which you can actually just plug in your parameters and try the actual code. The actual functionality. As I mentioned earlier, it will return that channel resource. And in the channel resource, in the response, you can actually see actually what you can get back. Like you can want to get the likes, the uploads, playlists, or you can get some statistics. And all other actual information will be available here. And the formats of those responses and the other parameters, as well as like the attributes depending on them, attached on them. So developer documentation is like really helpful for this. You can even like search developer documentation with additional problems like channels. You can actually go to documentation from there, or you can just use the sitemap on the left side, the left navigation. The second resource is the API blog. In API blog, we usually blog about the new things about YouTube API, what's changing, what is new, and all the other what's actually changing. May could be like even a change on the developer documentation or somewhere else, and they are really helpful. You'll get the most up-to-date information. So I really suggest you to subscribe to RSS feeds and get the updated documentation right away. In here, you'll see like the latest documentation in apiblog.youtube.com. You'll see your like the latest challenges or the differences, the latest updates on the YouTube APIs. You can do like a search. So today, actually, I want to talk about how to issue like a bug report or feature requests or get more help, like a one-to-one help from the YouTube APIs. And from there, we'll actually use like Stack Overflow and Issue Tracker. So I will actually search for a Stack Overflow blog. And September 14, 2012, like we actually issued a blog about that, talking about that we are not using the Google Groups anymore, but instead we are using the Stack Overflow for issue for the questions, coding questions, as well as the issue tracker for files and feature bugs and feature reports, feature requests. So Stack Overflow is a really nice community to ask the questions and get answers from like peer to peer. In that case, you can actually just all you need to use the YouTube-API, so we can track off all the questions about YouTube API, and we can get the answers right away. So far, we are actually trying our best to get all the questions answered over there, and you'll get your questions answered like really fast. Even before asking like a new question, you can just search for another question, or like you are trying to get like the thumbnail links, maybe you actually use like the YouTube API tag and ask for the thumbnails. Here you'll have like already an answer about the thumbnails, and you can just go ahead and just use the answer over there. Or if your question is not over there, you can just create a new question. If you're not going to use like their search engine, or you are just even for faster response, you can actually just use a Google search engine and just ask find your question. I use always like this kind of questions, like I use YouTube API tag, so I can, it's a YouTube API question, and then I say like how to set thumbnail. Maybe my question is about, I'm not doing PHP, I'm like maybe looking for a PHP answer, PHP coding answer. And here I can actually see that the thumbnail set operation, the method, is already here from the developer documentation, as well as like already people ask about the similar questions on Stack Overflow. As far as I can see here, I can just click the Stack Overflow question link here, and it will actually take me to the Stack Overflow question. And oh, someone already asked about how to set the custom thumbnails for videos, and there's a response already here, and they already agreed on that, so I can use the same response. Or if there's not enough, I can actually create like more comments at the end, or ask like a few another questions from Stack Overflow. But I really need to mention that Stack Overflow is a community to ask coding questions. So if your problem is more about like a YouTube's own thing about how the videos are handled, how the search is handled, or something not about API or not coding, then like Stack Overflow is not like a good platform for that one. And if you have like maybe you are like already trying something and you found the bug, or maybe the server is like not responding for your method, and you want to actually like issue a bug, so rather than like creating a question in Stack Overflow, we highly recommend you to use the issue tracker. It's under code.google.com/p/g.issues. g.issues. It's the open public issue tracker that you can actually find your other issues over there, or you can create a new issue or a feature request. To find like the YouTube issues, you can actually use API:YouTube, and it will actually go through and find all the YouTube API problems, YouTube API issues. Maybe you are having like some issue with the course of them. And you see it's already like filed here, so you don't need to create another issue. And rather than that, you actually rather just go and start this issue. You can start this issue, or you can create your own problem. Maybe it's in the same under the same topic, so you'll actually be notified when this issue is fixed, or someone else has like a similar problem, or found a different solution. Rather than creating a new one, that's really helpful. And it's also helpful for us because we can actually track how many people having this issue, and if this issue is like really critical, or this issue is like really valid, that so many people already filed this issue, or this feature request is like really on high demand. So we can prioritize things like way easier if you, rather than that, creating like this duplicate issue, just go into issue and write your own stuff or start this issue. So we highly suggest people to use for their feature requests or bug filing to use the g.issue tracker. And in the block itself, you will see the already templates here. either a Stack Overflow template that will create a Stack Overflow question, or there will be filing a bug one that will create a template for you, a YouTube defect report, which will show you like the which API was affected of that, or the steps to reproduce the issue. So you can say that, oh, I used this API method call, my code was like this, and it returned me like this. Or when you did this parameters, the response was like that. So we can easily reproduce the issue and can help you like way faster. Or you may just want to actually create a feature request using another template here, filing a feature request. And you will see that you create a request and the reason for this feature, how it can help you, and things like that. You can even like list the existing open bugs. We always ask you to check the list of existing open bugs before filing a duplicate request. So you just create this one. You actually click the list of open APIs. As you see, it will actually check the label -API YouTube, or you can just do the API : YouTube as well. So today we actually go over the four different ways of getting help. First one was the going to developer.google.com/YouTube or developer documentation. Second one was API blog using the apiblog.youtube.com. Third one was asking a coding question on Stack Overflow and getting like peer-to-peer help or getting help from us directly from here. Or if it was like a server issue, if it was like any issue, like you want to file a bug or create a feature request, you can just use the JData issue tracker. So these were the things that actually I want to go over today. And as the last thing, I want to mention that as developer relations team, we are hiring almost everywhere around the world. And you go into developers.google.com/jobs, you will see all the open positions, as well as like descriptions of all the available jobs. And we recommend just checking out and maybe there's like something for you. And that was all the things that I want to talk about today. Thanks for joining me, Ibrahim Ulkaya from New York.